Redwood City in 1913. The boss was rich and the poor were slaves. The women working, the children hungry, till along came lurking like a mighty wave. The workmen cringed when the busman thundered, and just 10 hours was his daily chore. He asked for little, but less was granted. Less getting little, he would ask for more. Then God said, "Larkin, tall, dark and handsome, a mighty man with a mighty tongue, a voice of justice, a voice of courage." And he was gifted and he was young. And God sent Larkin in 1913, this mighty man with his mighty tongue. He raised the workers, he gave them courage, for he was a leader, a worker's son. In the month of August, the busman told us, no union men for him could work. We stood by Larkin, we told the busman, we'd fight or die, but we would not shirk. 8 months we fought and 8 months we starved. We stood by Larkin through thick and thin, but foodless homes and the crying of children, they broke our hearts and we could not win. Then Larkin left us, we seemed defeated. The night was black for the working man. Till on came Connolly with hope and counsel. His motto was that we'd rise again. In Dublin City in 1916, the British soldiers, they stormed the town. They shelled our buildings and shot our leaders. The harp was buried beneath the crown. They shot McDermott and Pearson Plunkett. They shot McDonough and Clark the Brave. From Bleak Kilmainham they took their bodies to Arbor Hill to a quicklime grave. But most of all are the 7 heroes else in the praise of James Connolly. Voice of justice, a voice of freedom, he gave his life that we might be free.